okay, this workout is going to combine a lot of what I do in all of my beginner workouts. Every time I teach a beginner workout, I usually combine something a little bit more intricate into it. But this one's really nice because it combines everything that we do in whether you're swinging the kettlebell, whether you're doing an ab workout, but it keeps it very basic. None of this twisting stuff is going to confuse you, and you're going to get a great leg workout, ab workout, and arm workout all from this one. Okay, so at any time that I'm standing up and I'm doing something, you're always welcome to sit on your knees, go into a lunge position. In that lunge position, you should be able to really understand how to hold your core in a little bit better position. So we're going to start out. I'm going to start on my knees, and I'm using my big boy. So I always like to use the big boy so that I'm actually getting a workout while I teach you. You're welcome to use your smaller weight. Just feel it out. Always listen to your body and go with what you feel is most comfortable. So we're going to start out in a bicep curl. So go ahead, hold that at a 90 degree angle, and then lift it as high as you can. Pinch it at the top and go back down. We have two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Switch that to the other side. For 10, we have one, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Going to come on up into a half lunge position. I'm going to hold my weight and do a one arm row with that. I go one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Switch that on the other side. We have one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Okay, go ahead and sit down. While in a seated position, we're going to take the kettlebell, hold it in between our hands, and take those elbows and try to lean backwards, almost touch them down to the ground. Let's do 20 of those. We go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, high chest. 7, 8, 9, and 10. Sit that kettlebell down in the middle. So you extend it out a little bit. Get a little stretch in there, butterfly stretch. One leg out. Stretch it out. Anytime your heart rate's up like this, never lower that chest down. Keep the chest up, you can still get a nice stretch in. And go on the other leg. Okay, while we're still down here, we're going to do a stamp. We're going to take that weight, stamp it in the middle, stamp it on the side, middle, side. Just keep stamping it back and forth. The less you actually let that weight hit the ground, the more ab workout's going to be. Also, the higher you hold the chest, the more ab workout's going to be. And press your thighs down into the ground, okay? It's not about how many you do, it's about your technique and just going a long time. So we're going to go for 1 minute. We go one, two, three. Keep up with me. Keep on going. Keep that chest nice and high. Clamp those legs down. And work it out. Have nice wide elbows as you do this. Point your toes to hold even more stability. Halfway. Last one. And stop. Ooh, I'm feeling that.
Okay.
I'm gonna come up on both knees, hold that weight out in front of you, and we're gonna lift it up from the bottom position up and hold it underneath. Okay? Give me 10 of those. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Nice. Okay, so as you see, everything we're doing so far, it doesn't require any twisting with your body. All really nice and easy. So now let's go ahead and stand up with that weight. As you're standing up, you're welcome to do this on one knee. On that one knee, you're gonna take the weight, touch it to the ground forward, twist over like you're grabbing a gun in its holster. So go down, twist. I prefer to do the standing up, so I'm gonna stand up when I do it. Okay, same thing. I'm kind of twisted. I touch forward on the knee, and I twist back. We're gonna do 8 of those on each side. We go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. I'm switch it off. Leg out, other leg back. Keep your abs nice and tight. Just 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Okay, now we're gonna work on our lower back muscles. For the lower back, you wanna keep your legs as tight as you possibly can. You'll see a lot of people do this in kettlebell workouts, and I don't really recommend it for beginners while you're swinging the weight around, but just to get a lower back workout, it's perfect. We're gonna hold the kettlebell and stamp to the ground really nice and slow. Stamp down and come up. That's it. You notice my knees didn't move at all as I did that? We're gonna do 10 of those. 1, 2, 3. Also, don't lift your chest up as you do that. Keep everything aligned. The only focal point is your hips. 3 more. 1, 2, and 3. Really nice. Now we're gonna move right into a shoulder press. Hold that weight just in one hand. Stand on one leg, take your ribs over the leg that you're standing on, put your hips over on the opposite leg. Shouldn't really need any weight on that leg. Now from there, let's pump it up. We go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and switch. We're almost done, guys. Good job, keep it up. Let's go. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Go ahead and bring that weight down. Now you want to learn how to flow with your body. Whatever muscle's sore, don't work on it, but go ahead and work on the other muscles. Let's just stretch your arms out right now, swing them out a little bit. One arm across the chest. And switch to the other side. So we're about 75% finished. I'm gonna keep your muscles nice and limber. As you get further in the workout, you wanna stretch a little bit more. Okay, so to wrap it up, we're gonna do a one-arm row again, do those deadlifts where we lock our legs, and we're done. I'm gonna start out on my left arm. One-arm row, we have it down. Let's go a little bit faster this time. Let's do this. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. High chest, 6, 7, 8, 9, and switch. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and stop. No break at all. We have one more set of the day. That's our deadlifts going down. Give it pretty hard and just go to failure. I'm gonna try to get about 20 in. If you get 10 and you wanna stop, you're more than welcome to. You wanna beat me and get 30, 40, go for it. Let's do this. We have 1, 2, three, squeeze your inner thighs, four, five, six, seven, shoulders on the back as you come up, eight, nine, 10, halfway for me, breathe out, one, two, nice strong core, three, four, five more and you're done, six, seven, eight, two more, nine, 10. Great job, that's a very easy beginner workout. Do that with your baby weight or your big boy. Get a great strong workout, got lower back, biceps, glutes, quads, all around great workout. Good job, guys.